was really painful, really frustrating to watch Sriansh crying in pain.
I knew when I saw him and saw his symptoms that he was going to stay in that same infant state his entire life. But replacing the gene that was missing had the promise of completely changing his outcome.
When you deliver that medication at the right time, at the right location, that can help the orchestration of the brain act correctly.
This is one of the most transformative things I've experienced in 25 years.
Say hello, this is Sriansh Oza. He's a survivor. When I first started notice something was wrong when Sriansh was 2.5 months old, it was the second week of October. He used to take a nap. He was, struggling, like while taking a bottle. He was not able to lift his head up like the normal kids does around that time. He used to cry a lot for an hour or so, and then it was really hard for us to calm down. Nobody can calm him down.
So the key characteristics that make this diagnosis are the posturing, where the muscles get a signal and get stuck, and the deviation of the eyes to one side and getting stuck in a way that's different from eye deviation that happens in seizures. At Cincinnati Children's, we determined that the diagnosis was amino acid decarboxylase deficiency. So amino acid decarboxylase deficiency can be abbreviated AADC, which is an easier thing to say. In the severe cases like this one, you don't make any dopamine, or you just make a teeny amount of it and a teeny amount of serotonin. But in the severe cases that we see in babies this young, they don't have the necessary brain chemicals to learn new things, including to learn to move. And so as a result, they stay in the state of a baby their whole lives. They don't learn to sit, stand, walk, or speak.
I knew that that's very rare neuro disease, but at the same time, like, I was sad and crying and just begging for the help that, you know, like, please save my son.
We use a system called ClearPoint. That's a way of using a head frame that is placed on the scalp. It's something that allows us to then generate a precise location based on Sriansh's MRI that he's done. So as he lays in the MRI scanner completely asleep, we have this clear plastic frame that's placed on top of the head. And with those markers, we're able to adjust in a precise location directly how that catheter is going to go down in a bird's eye view. So what that means is we're looking at multiple different angles of the brain all at once using MRI before we've even made an incision to know that we're going to get to the right location. Here for Sriansh, it was a delivery of this gene replacement. So a medication that can be delivered slowly and gently within that exact location. So precision was quite important.
Oh, you're going to do it? Okay, you try.
We were completely shocked. We could not believe first. When we entered inside, Sriansh was there, lifting his head off, and he smiled at us. It was wonderful.
This is the way that a missing gene can be put in the brain in the place where it's needed. In a one single day treatment, and then produce what's needed for the rest of the child's life is amazing. So he went from the baby that I had seen that could barely have any head control to the way he was when I walked into the room, which he was just sitting there looking at me. And it was unbelievable. I'll never forget it.
Bye.
Bye. Go to the school.
He started preschools already, and then he's with around other kids, and so I think he's doing great.
He's got a fabulous family. His older sister's terrific. They're gonna keep working with him and getting him everything that they possibly can. This completely changed his outcome.
Cincinnati Children's is the one who saves my son's life.